Good morning, everybody. How are you? Obviously, fine. You all have taken 3 months of COVID-19 vacation. So now I know it's quite difficult for you to get back to your academics, but children, we have no option. Fine. So please get ready with your PDF file or textbook, all your stuff, because we are going to start our lesson number one, rational numbers in maths. Okay. Now, rational numbers. Now, before we move on to rational numbers, let me just revise what is the natural numbers. Natural numbers, anybody? Yes, natural numbers means all the positive numbers starting from 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, ... to infinity. So, which is the smallest rational number? Which is the smallest natural number? It is 1. And is there a largest number? Can you find the end of any natural number? No. They are endless. So, we write as infinity. Okay? So, these are natural numbers. Next is whole numbers. Now, what are whole numbers? Whole numbers means they start from 0. 1, 2, 3, to infinity. So, children, can you tell me what is the difference between natural number and whole number? Is there any difference? Can you see? Both are positive. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4 till infinity. What is the difference? Anybody? Yes, the difference is 0. The whole numbers, they start with 0, and natural numbers, they start with 1. So, 0 is not included in natural numbers, but whole numbers start from 0. Okay? So, this is the only difference between natural numbers and whole numbers. Then comes integers. What are integers? Integers means the collection of positive numbers, 0 and negative numbers. Integers means they are the collection of positive numbers, negative numbers and 0. Together, this whole group makes integers. Right? So, natural numbers, whole numbers and integers. Still we have real numbers and all that. But from this comes the main thing is rational numbers. Now, what are rational numbers? Rational numbers means the numbers which can be given P upon Q form. The numbers which can be given P upon Q form, where Q is not equal to 0 and P is an integer. Right? Now, children, you should have in mind that when I speak integer, means it can be a negative number, it can be a 0, or it can be a positive number. When I say a natural number, it has to be in your mind that it cannot be 0, it cannot be a negative number. And when I say a whole number, means it can be 0 or it can be any positive number. So you should have the key knowledge of natural numbers, whole numbers and integers, right? So, rational number means the number which can be given P upon Q form, given that Q is not equal to 0 and P is any integer. Means the numerator, this P can be a negative number, can be a 0 or can be a positive number, and Q can never be equal to 0. Can you have a denominator as 0? Is it possible? No. So, these are the conditions for the rational number. Understood? Okay. Now, we will see about the properties of rational numbers. Let us see about the properties of rational numbers. Let us see the problem. properties of rational number. Now in rational numbers, first property is closure property. You can see on page number 2, closure property. Okay, now in closure property, again you have addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Now we are going to study the closure property for whole numbers. Okay, whole numbers. Now whole numbers means you should have in mind, when I say whole numbers means starts from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, blah blah blah, all the positive numbers, right? Okay, now what does closure property say? Closure property for addition. So now if I tell you that if I take two whole numbers, when I take two whole numbers means I can take 0 and any positive number. Okay, so if I take two whole numbers, suppose if I take 0 and 5, so if I do 0 plus 5, what is the answer? 5. Right? 0 plus 5 is 5. So, what does closure property for addition say? That when you add two whole numbers, the answer is also a whole number. Right? When you add two whole numbers, the answer is also a whole number. This is closure property for addition, right? So 0 plus 5. 0 is a whole number? Yes. 5 is a whole number? Yes. The answer that you get, is that a whole number? Yes. Then closure property for addition for whole numbers is true. Understood? Okay. Now let us say subtraction. Just keep in mind, children, we are talking about whole numbers. We are not talking about integers. When we come to integers, we will be able to take negative numbers. Why cannot I take negative number over here? Because I am talking about whole numbers and negative numbers are not included in the whole numbers. Which numbers can you include in whole numbers? 0 and all the positive numbers. Okay, fine. Now let us say closure property for subtraction. Let us see, is it true? Fine. Okay, now let me say for subtraction. If I take subtraction 5, okay, if I take whole number 5 minus 7. 5 minus 7. What is 5 minus 7? Minus 2. Yes? 5 minus 7 is minus 2. Now let me see. Is 5 a whole number? Yes. Is 7 a whole number? Yes. But when I subtract 5 minus 7, I get the answer as minus 2. Minus 2 is a negative number. Now does negative number come in whole numbers? Do we include negative numbers? No. So when I subtract two whole numbers, I may not necessarily get whole number. When I do 7 minus 5, I get as 2. But when I do 5 minus 7, I get minus 2. So subtraction for whole numbers is not true. Right? Understood? So it is not closed under whole numbers. Understood till here? Fine. Now comes multiplication. Okay. Now let me take two numbers. Suppose if I take 2 multiply by 5 gives me 10. If I take 0 multiply by 7 gives me 0. So when I multiply two whole numbers, 2 answer is 10. Again, it's a whole number. 0 is a whole number, 7 is a whole number, answer is 0, it's a whole number. So when I take two whole numbers and when I multiply, I get to 0 or any other number as the whole number. So always when I multiply two whole numbers, the answer is always a whole number. So closure property for multiplication is true. Understood? Okay. And the last one is division. Okay. Suppose if I give you, you can see here in the example, suppose 5 divided by 8, right? 5 divided by 8, whatever answer I get, it is not going to be a whole number. Okay, 5 divided by 8, I will get 0 point something. So it is not going to be a whole number. So closure property for division is not true. Understood till here? Okay, so let me first explain you once again in short that whole numbers, which numbers can we include? 0 and all the positive numbers. So when I add two whole numbers, I always get the answer as a whole number. When I subtract two whole numbers, I do not necessarily always get a whole number, so it is not true. Similarly, when I multiply two whole numbers, I always get a whole number, so it is true for multiplication. And for division, when I divide two whole numbers, I will not get a whole number as the answer, so it is not true for division. So closure property for whole numbers is true for addition and multiplication, and it is not true for division and subtraction. Understood till here? Okay, so this was closure property for whole numbers. So this is the thing that you have to remember. Now you can see closure property for integers. Okay, this is about whole numbers. Now the same thing we are going to check for integers. Now children, which numbers can you take over here? You can take negative numbers, you can take 0, and you can take positive numbers. So now let us check for addition. Let us check for addition. Suppose if I take integer, so now I can take negative also. So suppose if I take minus 3. Minus 3 plus 2. What is the answer? Minus 1. Right? Minus 3 plus 2 is equal to minus 1. This is an integer? Yes. This is an integer? Yes. The answer that we got is an integer? Yes. So when I add two integers, I always get the answer as an integer. So closure property for addition is true. Understood? You can see in your textbook. Second is subtraction. Suppose if I take subtraction, minus 3 minus 7, answer is minus 10. Minus 3 is an integer, 7 is an integer. When I subtract two integers, I get the answer minus 10, which is also an integer, right? So again, closure property for subtraction is true for integers, right? Then comes multiplication. Let me tell you about multiplication. Suppose minus 2 multiplied by minus 3. Answer is 6. Okay, so minus 2 multiplied by minus 3. Minus 2 is an integer, minus 3 is an integer, 6 is also an integer. So closure property for multiplication is also true. It is closed, right? And the last one is division. Suppose if you take minus 3 divided by 5, whatever answer you get will not be an integer. So it is not closed for division. Understood everybody? Fine. So the difference is for whole numbers and integers. In integers, you can include negative numbers, but for whole numbers, you cannot include the negative numbers. So first of all, today we studied about the closure property for whole numbers and integers. For whole numbers, we saw that closure property is closed, or it is true for addition and multiplication, and it is not true for subtraction and division. Closure property for integers, it is true for addition, subtraction and multiplication, but it is not true for division. Understood till here? Okay, so tomorrow we will continue with closure property for rational numbers. So in today's chapter, whatever we have studied, please children go through it, so that tomorrow when we continue the lecture, you are clear with all these ideas and the knowledge is there with you. Fine. Thank you.